Hello, beautiful people. How are you today? I have some great news for those of you who are in the YouTube Partner Program. Specifically, because one of the updates that snuck by me, and apparently it snuck by a few other people because I didn't see any other videos about this, there has been an update to our YouTube cards that we can add to our videos. Now, once again, I will stress, you need to be in the YouTube Partner Program in order for this update to apply. So if you're not there yet, that's okay. It will happen in time. Just keep at it. And when you reach those thresholds that you need to reach, then you will be part of this exciting update. I also placed a poll over in at the top of the chat if you're watching live. So go ahead and vote on the poll and let me know if you're part of the YouTube Partner Program yet or not. And I will say hi to Tech for Your Needs. Thank you so much. First, I've got to tell you how I discovered this update. Okay, I have to clue you in on how I discovered this update. I have a new home for my podcast, The Anchor Show. Now, it's the same domain that it always was, but I migrated over to a new service that I'm using now, and the website is The Anchor Show, theanchorshow.com. So you could go check that out if you want. And I wanted to just go through all the things that I needed to do in order to get this site all set up. And so the prior service that I was using, I was not able to add a link to my YouTube video back to the Anchor Show. It's a long story, but it just didn't work. But now, guess what? That's not going to matter, even though I did move the website, and I'm still glad I moved it. But here is the update that YouTube has made. See if I can get this. I'll see if I can get this over here so you can see it. And let me get all my ducks in a row here. And I'm going to do a screen share. Now, I'm just going to make this bigger so that you can read it. And it's, we've updated the way you link to external websites from cards and end screens. Previously, you had the option to link to an associated website or approve merchandise and crowdfunding websites. Now, eligible creators can link to any external website that complies with our policies, including our community guidelines and terms of service. OMG. So now, before you get carried away with this, all right, I want you to make sure that you do go over and look at the community guidelines and terms of service, okay? So I'm not going to go through them all, but I'm just going to share them really quickly. And in fact, I'm going to put a link to this help article into the chat here. And it's actually, it's on a Google support site. Okay, I'll put that there. And I will also leave the link in the description of the video if you're watching this in a replay. And just a quick look over here at the community guidelines. And you'll see that, you know, it's pretty much any site that, you know, is not spammy or deceptive, have sensitive content, all those things that would get your videos banned anyway, doesn't have regulated goods on it, you know, firearms and illegal things and, you know, hate speech, misinformation. You can go through and read all of these yourself. I just want to, since I am bringing you this news, I want you to be aware that you should definitely check. And now here's the terms of service. And each one of these terms also has more information for you to click through. I'm not going to go through all the terms of service. If you're in the YouTube partner program, you've already agreed to this. And, you know, you should always be updated and making sure that you're a good steward of the community. So I thought this was a really important update and I wanted to share it with you. So now I'm going to show you what it looks like to link to one of your websites, or maybe you could even use this for your affiliate marketing. So, as I stated, I was not able to do this before, and we used to have this area on YouTube that was called Associated Websites, and that's how I found this, because I couldn't find the Associated Website where we're supposed to add our associated website. And so I was like, maybe I'm searching for the wrong thing and all this. And then I found this help article. I finally keyed in the correct terminology because I think I was just keying in searches about YouTube cards, but I found the associated website. Those were the keywords that I needed to plug in to you. Google support, or it's YouTube support, but it's under Google. And that's where I found that link, support.google.com/YouTube, answer number, and there's a bunch of numbers there. I'll put it up on screen again so you can see that. And I'll just leave it there for a second. And then Sharpfin is here and they said, hello, Eileen. Hello. Yeah, so this is really, I think it's going to be super helpful, and it's also going to be something you need to keep in mind when you're making your videos now, because now you know that instead of just saying, here's a card, go watch this video, or, you know, here's a card and head over to my website, it could also be, like I said, it could be someone else's website. It could be an important article, like I will probably add a card that links over to this Google support document, but I also will add a card because I want you guys to check out my theanchorshow.com. This is how I ran across this tip. So really quickly, let's go back into the back end of my YouTube studio, and I'm just going to add a link just so you can see it in action. All right. So here we go. I'm in my content area, and forgive me for not having everything all lined up. And I'm going to, because I want to link to the Anchor show and I have a lot of tutorials about Anchor, I'll just pull up one of my popular videos about Anchor. All right. So here's this one. It probably already has a card there. All right. Yes, we already have a card. And external, I have to accept your use of external links must comply with AdWords policies, YouTube ad policies, and YouTube community guidelines. Don't use external links to redirect traffic across domains. Any violation of these policies may result in removal of the feature and or termination of your YouTube channel. OMG, how cool is that? So there you go. That this really is a new feature because it's just asking me this. So let's see here if this is one that I want to change here. And this is linking to my website where I was talking about Streamyard. So we'll keep that in there. And this one was linking to a playlist. So I'm going to remove that one. That was linking to a playlist. Okay, move the position a little. You don't want to put the card up right at the very beginning. So you see it's at the 1 minute, 44 second mark. I'm going to add a card. I'm going to add a link. And I'm going to put in, I always put in that HTTPS theanchorshow.com. And there you go. I got no warnings. And you, I do have to still upload an image. And I'll just upload an image from that page. And I will just, you have to add in a call to action. And I will just say, follow. You know, you don't say subscribe anymore with podcasts. You say follow. And I'm just going to say the Anchor Show. There you have it. I added a link. Don't have to worry about the whole idea of having associated websites anymore. And there's another comment that came in here. So are the cards sort of like tags? Sorry, I was a bit tardy. No, the cards can provide links to external websites. So it's a call to action. It's nothing like tags. It's nothing about surfacing your video or getting your video found and things like that. I was having a little problems resizing that comment. There you go. I got it fixed. It's nothing about that. This is about calls to action for your audience. Now, keep in mind, you don't want to overdo this and adding a bunch of links to your videos, because people, you want people to be on YouTube and watch your video and consume your content. Okay? So you're only going to add cards that make sense. And you can also track the performance of your cards in your YouTube studio. Okay, so we'll go over that in another video. I don't want this video to be too long. I just wanted to make sure that this news gets out and you can now link to external websites that do not have to be your own. You do not have to have them claimed on your Google Search Console or any of that stuff that we used to have. This is a change. I haven't even actually heard the folks at YouTube talking about it. And so if you're watching, you're one of the first to know. And even if you're watching this in a replay, I appreciate you so very much. And for podcasting news and updates, go over to the Anchor Show. Other than that, I will see you in the next video right here on the Miss Eileen Speaks YouTube channel. So, as always, stay beautiful.